Hello, my name is James DeDecker. I am a field crop and bioenergy educator with Michigan State University Extension. In today's short presentation, I'm going to attempt to answer the question, what is the ethanol blend wall? In November of 2013, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency released its proposed Renewable Fuel Standards, or RFS, for 2014, including a controversial reduction in federally mandated volumes for renewable fuels like ethanol. The proposed policy would limit total domestic corn ethanol use to 13 billion gallons and cut the cellulosic ethanol goal to 17 million gallons. The agency has suggested that proposed reductions to the RFS volumes are based upon their projections of biofuel volumes that can likely be produced and used domestically in 2014. Two significant obstacles limit the ability of the U.S. market to absorb any more of what is currently the most economical biofuel, ethanol. Ethanol is most commonly blended with petroleum-based gasoline as E10. Overall, U.S. consumption of gasoline has declined by 0.5 to 0.8% annually for several years. Reduced consumption is partially the result of advances in vehicle fuel efficiency. The real sticking point, however, is the fact that current market forces and policy limit the rate at which ethanol can be blended with gasoline, together creating what is known as the blend wall. For decades, the Clean Air Act has imposed a regulatory cap on the amount of ethanol that can be blended with gasoline at 10% by volume. The E10 cap is at least partially motivated by the U.S. automotive industry's long-term position that fuel blends higher than 10% ethanol have the potential to damage vehicles and thus void many manufacturers' warranties. This is despite the results of a 2011 study by the Department of Energy, finding that fuel blends containing as much as 15% ethanol caused no significant damage to vehicles manufactured after 2001. Beyond that, flex fuel vehicles that can burn as much as 75% ethanol as E85 have been available for years, but unfortunately account for only 3% of America's light-duty fleet. In addition, only 10% of flex fuel vehicles on the road actually use E85. Some suggest that the lower energy content by volume and relative miles per gallon provided by E85 may be to blame for its limited acceptance in the marketplace. If gasoline consumption remains near 130 billion gallons in 2014 as projected, the 10% blend wall will continue to limit ethanol use to approximately 13 billion gallons. The revised RFS anticipates that nearly the entire 2014 ethanol mandate will be fulfilled by ethanol derived from corn grain. However, recent construction of three lignocellulosic ethanol biorefineries in the Midwest has reinvigorated hope for the scalability of plants fermenting fuel from corn stover. Many in the bioenergy and corn industries feel that proposed changes to the RFS could discourage this kind of positive development in biofuels. Cellulosic ethanol provides a higher net energy balance and avoids the food versus fuel debate by relying on low-value biomass rather than grain. However, if the ethanol market and RFS mandated volumes continue to show signs of instability, investors could easily get cold feet. Innovative approaches to using more ethanol, such as blending pumps, could provide a partial solution, keeping the door open for cellulosic ethanol. Blending pumps allow the consumer to select their blend according to manufacturer's recommendations or their preference, and simultaneously control costs for retailers wary of installing separate E15 or E85 pumps. If the blend wall is left as is and the image of higher ethanol blends is not improved, it will be very difficult to boost ethanol consumption in the U.S. much beyond current levels. Alternatively, slow investment in higher ethanol blends over time and the promotion of compatible vehicle designs would build on the success of grain ethanol and support the next generation of even more efficient bio-based transportation fuels. If you would like to learn more about this topic, I encourage you to access some of the references listed here. Thank you for your time.